Your right hand is filled with saving justice. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You are all here.
And also here.
A very warm welcome back to St Laurence's this morning. This is our first Sunday Mass in the fall, very nearly 4 months. It's been a long time. So, welcome back. In these strange times, we're having to do things rather differently. I expect you already emails last night, but if not, can I just remind you of some things? Important above all to keep safe. We'll have some vulnerable people worshipping here today. Please make sure you keep 2 meters between yourself and anybody else, no matter how pleased you are to see them. Please keep a safe distance. No singing, sadly, or shouting. Apparently, shouting can convey infection as well as singing. People will be playing through the Mass at key moments. Do please listen to the organ, please don't talk through it. Many people will be using music in the sense to nurture their weary souls, so please respect those who are really enjoying music. There's a one-way system through the church, please respect that. The main door is now entrance only, and the exit is through the side door here on the side of the church. Do please follow the direction of the church walls at all times. We've worked out exactly how to keep people safe from each other. There's going to be no physical peace. Do please, by all means, smile at each other, bow, with no touching peace, and no collection. Instead, there's a box at the entrance, and there's another box over there in the exit if you missed it on the way in. And money in quarantine for 72 hours before we do be counted by the church. In today's gospel, Jesus says, "Come to me, all you who suffer and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." 3 months of anxiety, taking their toll of risk to the population of the world, I suppose, not just the United Kingdom or London. And so as we come back to worship God, we confess our weariness and our acts of selfishness over the last month and last for God's grace.
Almighty God. Our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against each other, in thought and words and deeds, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, for we are sinners of us, and grant that we may serve you.
The mighty God who gives all the true repentance, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life and hope, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to you from all earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you are the Lord of the Lord, you are the Lord of the Lord, you are the Lord of the Lord. Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The God, who in the amazement of your Son have raised up for the world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those who have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal plans. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
banished chariots from Ephraim and horses from Jerusalem. The bow of the war will be banished. He will proclaim peace for the nations. His empire shall stretch from sea to sea, from the river to the ends of the earth. This is the word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for revealing the mysteries of the kingdom to your children. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And also with
you. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord God. Yes, my yoke is easy, and my burden light. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Relocated it from their building, the old St Laurence, the some city buildings were bathed in blue light as part of that celebration. And we were encouraged to put a light in our windows as a sign of our support. I have to say, my neighbours didn't join me in that particular piece of celebration, but never mind. Thankfully, we do have this wonderful organisation. And at 5 o'clock this afternoon, there will be a public round of applause for our National Health Service. All our health service providers who enable the provision of the NHS, and that's doctors and nurses and drivers and porters and cleaners, admin staff, people that work in catering, building security, and my sincere apologies if I've missed any of the important people. It might be difficult for people under 72 years of age to really appreciate the wonder that is our NHS. So accepted is it as an established right. My mum would often tell me when I was growing up that before the NHS, the children of many of her neighbours died because they were unable to afford the relatively small amount of money that it cost to call on the services of a doctor. Something like 1 and 6 pence. 7.5p in decimal currency. Hard for us to imagine now, but it was a fact of life before the NHS. How would we have fared in the current pandemic that had it not been for our NHS? The call was, the call is to protect our NHS, and we need to listen to this call as we move forward into hopefully post. A time when our economy will be affected by the cost of the lockdown. A time to remind ourselves, perhaps, that the NHS that we celebrate this weekend actually came to be in an era when the economy needed to recover not from 4 months of lockdown, but from 6 years of war and destruction of homes and buildings and infrastructure. I think that's something for us to remember and to use as questions if we become aware of threats to services blamed on COVID-19 and lockdown. The second reading from today, from Romans, speaks of the Spirit making its home in us, the Spirit of God which says, love your neighbour as yourself. In the Gospel today, Jesus invites, Come to me, all you who labour and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. I expect there will be many health and social care workers and homeschooling parents who will respond with a resounding yes, please, to this. A blessing to take some respite, to feel loved and appreciated, a breathing space to recover the energy required to carry on. For we must carry on. The temptation may be to let down the guard in respect to social distancing and hygiene and take some risks, but this would be to invite a re-emergence of the pandemic and to be uncaring of our neighbours. And that's why we have this regime in church today with our arrows and our sanitizer and the need to keep distant, which is alien really to our concept of hugging and shaking hands and saying I care. But for the time being, we have to demonstrate our love for our neighbours by behaving responsibly. The last 4 months have seen volunteers stepping up, being real neighbours, shopping for isolated people, working behind the scenes, preparing and packing bags of foods and supplies for delivery to those in need, donating not only time and money, but food and other items like toiletries, giving time on the telephone to keep in touch with folk and friends, gaining new skills in social media to stay in touch with family and friends. And we acknowledge here the role of the voluntary organisations in our area for their organising skills. And we have been seeing people like bus drivers and railway staff, and postal workers and delivery workers, staff in supermarkets and pharmacies, and of course, the emergency. Those on this particular Sunday, I would like to remember to are those who work at sea. It's close to Sea Sunday. So the fishermen, the ferry crews, the merchant and Royal Navy personnel, and of course the volunteers of the RMRI, all actually risking their health and in some instances their lives to keep the systems going that we now rely on for our civilised existence. We do not have to be learned or clever or know how precious much of what we take for granted today is, but we do need to be determined that good establishments like the NHS that we inherited, our commitments to community, our willingness to volunteer when we can, and the new knowledge and skills we gained from recent experience, that these are maintained. A quote from something that was circulated on Aging Well to be friendly in WhatsApp, COVID-19 reminds us how fragile we are. Our friendships prove how strong we can be. So, love God and neighbour, and continue to exercise the consideration that we have shown during these past months. Protect that which is precious in justice, healthcare, and nature. Learn and be prepared to live in new ways that are kind to our environment, so that generations to come will know the wonder of God's love and his creation. If we do these things, His Spirit will find a home in us. Amen.
We believe in one God, in the Father of all the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that has been seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, of one being with the Father, during all things are made, for us and for us.
mindful of the humble nature of Jesus in his invitation to the sharing of your word with all who reason. Lord, in your mercy.
In your grace.
And we pray for our world, Lord. May leaders of nations and countries promote peace with justice, and their words and actions be for the well-being and comfort of all your children throughout the world. We look to those in power in this world to work and plan for justice and equality for all. And we ask for sharing and collaboration in the developments in research to combat disease for the greater good and the prevention of future pandemics. Lord, in your mercy.
In your grace.
And for our community, Lord, help us all to live your commandment, to love our neighbours as ourselves, and to demonstrate the transforming power of your love for all your creation, through care of our environments, sensitivity to the needs of others, and a willingness to demand justice and equality in all our communities. Lord, in your mercy.
In your grace.
Lord, we ask for the blessings of your healing on all suffering illness or disability of body, mind, or spirit. Thinking of those named on our prayer sheet and for others who may be known to us. We pray for those awaiting delayed treatment for existing conditions, if possible, and then for those whose disabilities are accentuated because of the law. For those suffering from depression and other mental health issues because of enforced isolation. And for all who mourn the passing of a loved one. Lord, in your mercy.
In your mercy.
Our prayers to you, Lord, for those who have died recently. We welcome you, Clarice Gulabi, and Roy Downey. And for those whose anniversaries occur at this time, Jacqueline Dean, Lionel Sunford, and Victoria Gomez. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. And rejoicing in the fellowship of St Laurence and all your saints, we commend ourselves and all Christian people to your unfailing love. Merciful Father,
have accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one by the blood of Christ. We meet in his name and share his peace. We are the peace of the Lord. Be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
thereby may bring our conduct closer to the life of Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give thanks and praise to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, for the Father, through whom you have raised all things, who was sent to our new Lord and purpose to be our Savior. And the power of your Spirit is of flesh, and that of your Son, born from the Blessed Virgin. He lived on earth and went to God's mouth. He opened my arms for some of the cross. He put an end to death by dying for it, and revealed the resurrection by Christ into life. So he fulfilled your will of one for your holy people. Therefore, the angels and dark angels, and the Lord, the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, and our friends in you and say,
Holy, holy, holy Lord.
Great is the mystery of faith. Christ is our end. Christ is the end. Christ is our end. And so far. For his life, his death, and his cross. His perfect sacrifice made once for sins of the whole world. Rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate as the Lord of our redemption. As we offer this, our sacrifice, praise, and thanksgiving, bring before you his bread and his cup. And we thank you for countless words to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather to one more kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup. That we can come from the lives of all the saints. May praise and glory from you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom and in you, in using the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory to yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
To break his bread, to share the body of Christ.
Takes place.
Happy are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only to say goodbye.
For communion, please follow the directions of the church walls. We'll bring them onto your pew, probably pew by pew. When you come to receive, please simply hold out your hands, and I will drop the host into your hands without touching you, and please don't touch me even with it. That will be all keep safe. Please don't say amen when I offer you the host, because the less we can say to each other, the better.
Thank you.
may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for the notices. Well, it's lovely to be back after such a long period of absence. Who knows how many more lockdowns may have been to endure, but regardless, thanks to God for the freedom that we now have to return to church, even if things are a little unusual. But as the weeks progress, we shall soon get used to this new way of doing liturgy, and when finally we are allowed to sing once more, very good choice. But in the meantime, thank you very much indeed to all those who have kept things going during this difficult period. Particular thanks to Peter Charles, who's a pioneer of our digital ministry, which has enabled congregations to stay together, all being remotely, through this difficult time. So many thanks to Peter for all your work on researching and bringing about ways of keeping the congregation in the loop and being able to share things with each other. I think about six or eight different social networks that these are coming to masterminds. So it's a lot of work, and the fruits are, I think, in the sense of the congregation, still very much feeling that they belong here. Thank you to the editor of our organs this morning. They'd like our services over the next few Sundays. We're very grateful to you. This week, we'll be short of Chris on Wednesday. 10:30, normally we meet in the main chapel, but now it's going to be in the main church. That's 10:30 on Wednesday. We're not going to limit numbers to that because we're not expecting great crowds of people. So come on Wednesday, 10:30. Sadly, no refreshments afterwards. Hopefully that will come. And at 11:30, for those who aren't able to make it to church, as well as streaming this morning service, which Peter's doing at the moment, we're also broadcasting on Wednesday morning a Mass in the Living Chapel specifically for Facebook, which would be more in the style of the Sunday Eucharist we've become accustomed to, with the camera put straight in front of the altar. So for those of you who enjoyed that, very welcome to stream it Wednesday at 11:30, and it will be available on Facebook thereafter. On Thursday, once we're broadcasting the meditation at 5 p.m. on Thursday on Facebook, so do join her then, or catch up later. And St Laurence will be a group of private prayer during the week, normally 7:30 in the morning to about 7 p.m. A lot of people will be making use of over the last 2 weeks that we have been open. Very often I've been in the check if things all right. There are a couple of candles burning. So I think local people are using it quite a bit to come in and say their prayers during the week. If you're passing, do pop in, come with a nice candle, say a prayer, and make use of this lovely building to which we are now being admitted. Two private things. There is a collection box at the exit of the church. If you didn't get a chance to do it on the way in, you can put your collection into that. If you're catching up on your missing weeks, as it were, go and please ask for more than £30 in an envelope if you're eligible for gift aid. There are a couple of reasons for that, which I can explain if you're interested. So if you're catching up, please put and you have more than £30, but do make sure you're getting separate envelopes, please, because then you get some more money back from the government for the complicated reasons. Finally, at the end of Mass, there will be an organ voluntary at the end, which we're much looking forward to. Could I ask you please not to leave the church until the voluntary is finished? Because otherwise, we'd be getting out of our buildings, which could be a bit dangerous for him. It would be very, very much to be in around for this kind of point. The selfish reason is don't inherently invite him too close to my house. Instead, please enjoy the music and wait till it's over before you leave the church. And please come ask him not to hang around in groups outside the church if you wouldn't mind, because that again could be a source. Please stand for the
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus. Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessed God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you. Amen.
Amen.
Go.